water. My heart, I loved her. My heart.
Hello, did you not like the vine that you couldn't hear? I think audio is definitely the thing I struggle with the most. Just all the time. I don't know what's wrong with me. But that's fine. That's okay. Hello, Kyle. How are you doing? Thank you for being here. It's power wash today. So power wash we shall. I wish there was a way, and honestly, maybe there is. I wish there was a way that I could. Did you download the pool wash game yet? I have not yet. I'm going to basically as soon as I finish this, which I'm not far away from doing, to be fair. I've got this to finish, and then Midgar, and then we're done. I think it was pool wash that I've decided on doing next, basically as soon as I finish this, which I'm excited for. Amogus! You like him? Give him little claws as well. Can you hear the music okay? Or is it too quiet? Tyrannosaurus Rex. I'll do that last. Thank you. Anyway, how have you been? What's been going on? How's work, etc.? I was playing Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines yesterday. I've been playing it like on Tuesdays mostly the past like 3 weeks. And honestly, it's been so good. I can't believe I went this long without playing it. It's one of those games that I think if I'd played it when I was like 8 years ago or something. Or, like, if I played it when it came out, I think it would have, like, influenced me in formality ways. In formality ways? What the fuck am I talking about? Hang on, I need to turn on my little lights. Hey, Figur. Hey, Figur. Figur to turn on my lights. That's better. Now you gain nothing extra, and I get a little bit of a migraine. Isn't that great? But yeah, I reckon if I'd played like Bloodlines in my formative years, I think, I don't know, I'd be a lot weirder. So, one thing that I have been sort of... Oh, be kind of nasty. One thing that I've been kind of trying to encourage myself to do is just consume more media, and I realise that that's an insane thing to want to do, because everyone probably consumes too much media. But like, there are so many movies I haven't seen, there are so many games I haven't played, there are so many TV shows I've not seen, so many books I haven't read. And like, that's true for everyone, but I've missed out on so much, it's insane. I've not seen like The Godfather or The Matrix or any of the Indiana Jones movies or any of the Star Wars movies. I wish to consume more anime. Bleach. Also, hi Pisces, how's it going? Welcome in. Welcome in. Take a seat. How's your day been? Other programs keep distracting me. Oh yeah, you were talking about what was it called again? Children of the Whale or something? Which you recommended to me. You said it was on Disney Plus. I might be misremembering the name. Just had an amazing dinner. Ooh. What did you have? Spill the beans. I made chicken wings. Chicken wings and rice and veggies. It was very boring. It was very, like, very safe. I didn't really feel like cooking today, so I kind of just chose what was easy. But like, I've been like kind of cooking too much lately, so I just kind of couldn't really be bothered, you know? I'm doing mac and cheese tomorrow, which I'm excited for. I just sort of like, I don't know. I wish there was more light foods that I could make. You seem to be quite healthy with your meal choices. Good you. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I, try to be. I mean, I said I'm making mac and cheese tomorrow, so, I don't know. Honestly, most of my life has been, most of my, like, meal decision is just making a meal that I think sounds good and being like, oh, that's not very healthy, and then cramming a bunch of vegetables in it. Like, I made a bolognese / chili con carne, like, pasta bake yesterday. And I think it fucked hard, I'm not gonna lie. I think it needed, like, a long time to simmer to bring the flavor out, so it was a little bit bland for my liking. But I kind of got to a point where I was happy with it, and I was like, oh shit, it's not got any vegetables in it. So I added like onion, loads of mushrooms, carrots, and kidney beans, just to kind of fill out the nutrition a bit. Oh, this is Rayman music. This is Rayman 2. 100%. Hey Tiltle, how's it going? It's nice to see you. What's been going on? Anything exciting? But yeah, Pisces, what did you have for dinner? I'm curious. You say amazing dinner. Now I'm jealous. Just working. Yeah, me too. Someone like checked in on me today at work, because my boss is on holiday, and I'm kind of in a position of basically no responsibility. So if I don't have given work to do, then I sort of do nothing, which is like great for me, for the salary I'm on. But like, oh my god, I think I've never lied out of my ass so much, so quickly. I was like, oh, you know, just absolutely swamped, you know, these tickets, they keep coming in, and steak pie and mash really hit the spot as a fancy pastry. Oh, I kind of crave pastry. I've been trying really, really hard to be, like, better, like, health-wise, past, like, month or so. And, like, I was feeling kind of great, but I think it's definitely getting to me now. Jesus, there's so much to do in this level. Like, oh no, ooh, daggers. I wish I was familiar with Tomb Raider lore. I bet these would be very cool. I'm not much of a health kicker, to be honest. I don't really agree with any fad diets. I kind of think to myself, like, you know, eat what makes you happy. Then tweet, you know? But I think especially since moving out of my parents a few years ago, I've kinda... I don't know. Like, weirdly enough, it wasn't COVID. It wasn't COVID that caused that many problems for me. That might be a lie, actually. Like, I got into, like a relationship with Jaden, as you know, and we kind of both just really liked going out for food and getting treats and having things, so it's like, it's good, but it's my waistline, my poor waistline. I'm kind of trying to claw that back, because I saw pictures of myself from, like, 3.5 years ago, and I was, like, I wasn't visually healthy. I was just, like, right on the cusp of about to be, like, what I would consider, like, good-looking, and it, or what I would consider to be, like, you know, the body type that I want for me. And I was a bit like, oh, shit. I can't believe that of all the people to fall for the, like, oh, you really let yourself go. It was me. I did it to myself. My last job was terrible because I was the only one in my department and never got any help. I never got properly trained or supplied, so I'd have to BS my way through so much. And then there'd be periods of time where I didn't have anything to do. I would always pretend to be busy so they didn't make me help the other departments. That is, like, more or less what I do, like, exclusively. Like, that's right on the money. It's weird because, like, on one hand, having nothing to do is, it's like, it's a bit of a blessing, right? Because I think that being paid to do nothing might be the best feeling in the world. A lot of people actually disagree with me on that, which I think is very surprising. But I'm so unfulfilled. I'm so unfulfilled, and I'm so bored, and I can feel my brain rotting. There's, like, no stimulation. Which I guess is probably why people don't like to be paid to do nothing, right? Because, like, I can't even do, like, other stuff whilst I'm doing my nothing job. I can't. Like, I'll sometimes try. I only don't like it because I feel like I'm going to get caught, even though it's... Yeah. Yeah. That's something that I genuinely worry about. I'm like, what if... What if, like, one day everybody realizes that I've basically not done anything for God knows how long? I need to be doing something all the time. Yeah, I think most people are like that, right? Like, people like to have stuff to do. Got through half of your work part. Honestly, good for you. Are you hiring? Can I come work with you? Maybe my job in IT won't go anywhere. Only if you're serious. I mean, I am serious. But I guess I'm starting a new job in a few weeks, right? All right, have you got the ability? Like, to be perfectly honest with you, the new job that I'm going to is probably going to be good for me. I just, I don't want to do it. Because I simply do not dream of labor. I took a day off on Friday, and it was my first day, the first day that I'd taken off all year, and it felt amazing. I slept in. Oh, it was amazing. It was so good. I need a holiday. Like, just off of work. It doesn't need to be like, I don't need to go anywhere. I just need to not work. That's all I need. I'm excited. I've kind of got like some good weekends lined up, but I just know how shattered I'm gonna be, so I'm going to see my friend on Saturday. Going to like a work event, which is gonna be fine. Pisces, me and you are gonna be hanging out the week in a couple weeks or 3 weeks. That's going to be really, really fun. I'm really, really excited for that. We need to hang out before then as well, obviously. Which I very much want to do. I'm going to see if I can shuffle some things around. And maybe we can like hang out after work or something if you're not too tired. Bah, bah, bah. I'm going to Swindon. I'm going to go see Lucy. I'm going to be up there for such a long time. You know when you're thinking, oh, I will. As soon as I've got a kind of idea. This music is like, I don't know, it fits the vibe. Holy shit, is this Persona? Yeah, this is the Velvet Room. Ah, oh, fuck, I should really continue playing Persona 5. I've been obsessed with Nuclear Throne lately. I don't know why. This is gonna sound weird because, like, yesterday, I was kind of the mind that it was a lot later in the week than it was. But now I'm feeling like the weekend is approaching fast. I think what's happened is, I thought that I don't know how to say it. I kind of had some stuff going on that I thought would like kind of fill up my week. Starting Monday, and like it ended up like not really happening, so I've been kind of lost this week. So like when it hit yesterday, I was like, oh, what the fuck, man, what do you mean it's only Tuesday? I feel like an entire week has passed. And then you know, I've been spending basically an entire day being like, oh, I can't believe it. I can't believe it's so early in the week. And now, like, I'm streaming on Wednesday, so tomorrow is Thursday, and then it's basically the end of the week. I have so much fucking validation to do at work. I'm not excited for that. And for those of you who don't know, who are lucky enough to not know, validation. So I'm doing validation for an import we're doing on our system. And that means is I've been sent a test version of our system, and I've been sent an Excel spreadsheet, and I have to check that the things on the spreadsheet are in the system, and there are 25,000 entries on that spreadsheet, and I have to go through every single one of them, one by one. So I got that going for me, which is nice. I might go into the office tomorrow just to fucking feel something, you know? Is something that I always forget to say. Tell your friends you love them. Send tweet. Oh no, one of my friends told me that they loved me earlier, and it felt nice. Like, and it was more like more or less unprompted. It was just like, hey, just so you're aware, I appreciate you and I love you. And I was like, oh. So yeah, do that. It's nice. Sometimes people, I think, need to hear that. I think I needed to hear it, to be honest with you. So I appreciated it. I need to get, like, a rechargeable battery pack for this controller. Look at that. So clean. So majestic. So covered in tiny little yellow spots. Lara, my darling, I don't care. I literally don't give a shit. Sorry that happened, all good for you. Suit of armor. Who's Horus?
Who's there? Hey, where's
Horus and his brother Slutus. You didn't like that one? Lara, baby, text me back. I have so many funny jokes to share with you. Not to sound like an incel, but when I played the Tomb Raider reboots, honestly, the worst part about it for me, because I lived with my parents at the time, because they're like so obsessed with making Lara get hurt. She gets like stuff poked through her stomach and gets like massive cuts on her and stuff, and she like falls off of giant mountains and stuff. And like, you know, that's weird enough as it is, but it's the fact that she's like panting and screaming, like obviously as you would be in a situation like that, but like so often there'd just be like a prolonged sequence of Lara like panting for breath and gasping and making weird little whimpering sounds, and I had to be like, I didn't want that sound coming from my bedroom, you know, lest my mum think I'm doing anything devious. The case with nothing in it. Oh. Whatever it is, I want. This is like definitely less exciting than SpongeBob one, but that's fine. I miss the Persona music. I might go back and recreate one of my playlists, because I stopped using it because it kept muting my VOD, but I'm really missing it. I'm not lying. So there's this shirt, and I've not stopped thinking about it for 2 weeks now. I saw it in H&M, and it's £40, and it's like, so it's kind of like mesh see-through-y with kind of like red flowers on it, I think. And just like, I really liked it when I saw it, but then I was like, no, I'm being impulsive, there's no need for that. I can't afford it, etc, etc, etc. And now I think I want it desperately. Like, so desperately. But I can't find it, and it's making me very sad. There's been nothing... Oh no, I kind of realised that I need more, like party clothes. I've kind of like outgrown my style twice over the past year or so. And I'm trying to make up for that, and it's just not really possible. That's a ding from me. Who dares message me on Messenger? Answer of wisdom. Na 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 na. Ooh, now that's fun. Music's nice and spooky. I think something that everyone needs is time to themselves, like completely unfiltered. Hello! Can't stay, just wanted to say hi, Chris. Thank you so much for swinging by. Blonde hair, don't care. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for noticing. Yeah, thanks for swinging by as well. It's nice to hear from you. I hope you're doing fabulously. Yeah, I think something that everyone needs, like, to themselves is just time. I'm using Powerwash, I'm doing really good. It's okay, you don't need to be sorry. I'll be back next week. I'm glad you're doing well, though. It's nice to hear. I'm always happy to hear when you're thriving. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Just because I think the kind of like the ability to be alone is when people like consume the most and like do things that I think are, I don't know, like the most, I guess I've already said formative previously, but that's kind of what I mean. Like, it's when you find the TV shows that I think connect with you the most. It's when you find your favorite songs that you listen to over and over and over again. I had to check that our heating hadn't turned itself on. I hate you, Gnome. I hate you for being in here. I hate for what you stand. I hate what you stand for. I hate that you clip through the globe.
Fun. Very cool. Vera Bradley. To the window. Ooh. Nasty. I watched the Midnight Gospel, and it is something I watched like years ago. And I'm like continually disappointed it didn't get a second season. And I don't think I've met anybody else who has seen it, which is like fine, because to be honest with you, I don't, like, it's not great. But when I watched it, it kind of hit just all of the right nerves. Like, the, like, world that Pendleton Ward had created, the voiceovers from the podcast, the general just kind of nihilism, but also positive message from the whole thing. It really felt like... it felt like giving an objective worldview without coming off as feeling like centrist bullshit. And, you know, obviously it was in the style of like an Adventure Time cartoon as well, which helped digest it with all of the wacky messages and colours and stuff. And like, all of the audio, as far as I'm aware, is taken from a podcast. So I don't understand, like, how certain topics come up. So I think about that a lot. Okay, look. You have to be from a certain angle, eh? Once again, goes kind of off. Feet once again going nasty. I need some hashtag experiences. Spent way too much money on a hotel for a place I'm going to in a couple weeks, and I had to... I don't know. I'm still considering whether or not I'm even going or not. There's train strikes. I'm anxious. It's the whole thing, right? So who knows? But, like, I'd like to go. It's just a matter of convincing myself, right? You know, how everyone seems to have two minds over anything. I'm the same. Where are we going? Where do you want to go? I mean, I'm going to Swindon. This is not really very exciting. Like Winchester. I'm just going to see a friend. See Barbie. I am going to see Barbie, actually. Potentially this Friday, but maybe not. I actually keep forgetting to ask my friend. You need someone to talk you out of it, I can help. A date friend? No. Not a date friend. Just a regular close friend. God, I want to see Barbie so bad. I'm considering going on Friday, potentially, if you want to go. Also, hi Kip, how are you doing? What time? I have no idea. In the evening, most likely. I think I'm going to go after work. Ooh! You should. Tell me how it is. Just look and we'll get some bits and bobs done. Okay, no pressure or anything. I'll let you know if I have a time for Bobbly. Friday. Oh god, we might go see. Yeah, I'm listening to a mix of PlayStation music. Honestly, it's fucked and sucked so far. Kyle, it's weird to think that we'll probably be seeing Barbie at basically the same time. After work on Friday. Orb. I'm on Barbie, let's go party. I think the showing is at 4:50. Okay, so you'll see it a bit earlier than me. So, like, here's a weird question. Is the Barbie / Oppenheimer thing just a bit? Because I don't think I have any interest in seeing Oppenheimer. And, like, obviously I know that they're releasing on the same day, and it's, like, all a big joke, etc., etc., and a lot of people are going to see both of them. I don't know. I guess, like, part of the joke is that they're very different, and that's what makes it funny. Like when Animal Crossing and Doom Eternal came out on the same day. Just Barbie for me. Yeah, innit though? Just Barbie for me, thanks. I also don't have any pink clothes, which is kind of heartbreaking, but that's fine. I have a pink shirt. Very cool. I used to have, like, a pink, like, sweatshirt, like, jumpery, cardigan-y thing. I gave it to Jaden. Because... it was kind of too small for me. It gained a lot of weight. You know how it is. I looked like a giant piece of chewed bubblegum when I wore it. I have zero info about Oppenheimer, other than it's a thing with a bunch of A-listers in it that's coming out the same day as Barbie. Yeah, you basically know as much as me. I think it's got something to do with bombs and the war, maybe? Oppen homeless style? Oppenheimer style. Fuck's sake, Kip. Yo, beat goes kind of hard. Did anybody play Tamagotchi Corner Shop on the Nintendo DS? That was my shit back in the day. God, I missed it. And, like, I loved those games so much that, like, I got to the point where I would pirate. Because I think there were three of them. I pirated whatever the newest one was at the time. And then, like, I emulated it on my R4 cart with, like, a fan translation. So that I could play it early. Oh, it was good. Like, I only ever did that with Pokemon and Tamagotchi Corner Shop 3. Fucking worth it. I should like stream some like old DS games or something, just to kind of get myself the nostalgia kick. It'd be entirely for me, but that's fine. God, this goes hard. Did you ever use that Tamagotchi website that could connect to your Tamagotchis? No. That's so fucking cool. I've never even heard of that. You could do mini games and stuff and see their parent and grandparents. What? That's amazing. Does it still exist? Probably not, right? Dane of a snore. Oh, Tamagotchi. I really want a Tamagotchi. Me and Matt were talking about buying them a while ago. Like, kind of as a bit. and I pussied out. I think that they actually did buy one, but it's expensive. I have like three, maybe more. I have so many Tamagotchis. Tell me about your Tamagotchis. Do you want to borrow mine? I can see one from here. Maybe. I'll inquire. I'll inquire at a later date. We'll table this meeting. We'll circle back in the new fiscal year. I'm getting tired of working. every time someone sends me a message that's like, oh no, have you done our KPIs this week? I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? I hope you die. I'm sad to report Tamatown does not exist anymore. Oh, it got hit by the Oppenheimer bomb. The Tamagotchis are now going Oppa homeless style. Oppa boiled egg style. Hey, crispy babies. Oh. You don't like it? What's wrong? God, what is this from? It sounds like it's from fucking Chowgar. A Bomberman World! It's from Bomberman World. Bomberman World fucked hard. It's on the PS1. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Bomberman World content. So, no, she's not here. So, I got my friend a present, and it was, so like, as part of her present, I've got her a photo frame, and I was gonna like, print off a bunch of pictures for her, and like, if they're of like, me and her, then I would like, you know, write what we were doing on that day, or whatever. And there's also like pictures of like her dog and her and her sibling, or her and like when she was on holiday or whatever. And I think it's a cute idea. I like it. And I'm going to put like stickers around the frame and stuff, because like she like recently moved into like a new room. So I was like, oh, a little housewarming present, etc. I think it's really cute. And I kind of went, I went to one of these like print websites so I could like upload the photos and stuff. But I didn't have all of the photos like on the same device, so I wanted to check if I could like upload and then come back, and like would it remember what I'd uploaded, or do I have to like get them all on the same machine like right now and upload them from a folder? So to test it, I just chose like some random thing off my desktop and uploaded it. Quit, came back the next day, and it was still there. So I was like, oh cool. Like test complete, sorted. I deleted the photo I uploaded because obviously I don't want that to get printed. And then I started uploading the photos that I actually wanted. I uploaded 8 photos, and the preview for the 8 photos was the photo that I had uploaded, which I thought was weird. But then I like looked at the list, and it was like the 8 photos that I had uploaded. It was like, I want all of these, so great, you know? I thought it must have just been like a caching issue or something, like remembering the photo, but like that's obviously not what's going through. So I did that. I uploaded my photos, I bought them, paid for shipping. Paid for 8 photos, the 8 that I uploaded. I got the invoice. It said that I paid for 8 photos, and I got like an email saying, your 8 photos are on the way. And like, you know, this number 888. Obviously, because that's what I paid for. Why would I get more or less than that? And then, so today, the photos arrived. Beautifully printed, nice high quality. There are 9 of them, though. There are 9 photos. And actually, let me show you. Sorry, I'm coming closer now. This is nice and intimate. Hello. And like, I won't show you the photos for the other person's privacy and whatever. But I've got like, pictures from the holiday, pictures of us together, a dog, etc. And I've also. So that's yeah. That was a fun thing that happened. I'm trying to decide if I should put that in the photo frame I bought and give it to her as her present that way, just because it's fucking hilarious. Free tone with every purchase. And yeah. So or should I just put it somewhere random in the house? Because like the thing is, I was put it behind the picture frame as a secret. Oh, that's not a bad idea. That's not a bad idea. So here's the thing as well. In the photo frame, I was gonna put like a picture of me and her to be like, oh, like, nice because we're friends and I like spending time with you, etc. Because I'm sickly sweet like milk. I'm sweet like spoiled milk. I thought it was a cute idea. And then I also like got the other prints because I was like not being funny. If you think this is weird, I also got you like other prints that you can use and hang up. And I was just gonna like put those in an envelope and give it to her. Smelly like milk. But the idea of putting a frog, like hidden behind the picture of like me and her that I'm going to frame, is infinitely hilarious because I could be like frog of disapproval. Frog that knows your sins. Also, I don't know what it is. I love getting photos printed. Buggers printed. I actually really like getting photos printed. I don't know. It's nice. It's nice having like physical photos. Which, like, feels weird because like they're just photos, dog. But
I don't know, Dutch.
Feels nice. Feels good. Feels analog. I'm not much of an analog person, but appreciates it. I appreciate any form of like analog art, I guess. I mean, like a photo of me where I'm sticking my tongue out isn't really what I would call analog art, but you know.
Ooh.
I'm kind of still hungry. I had quite a big dinner. Lots of vegetables. And I did absolutely demolish those chicken wings. I was talking to my friend. I want dessert. Oh. Do we not have ice cream sandwiches in the freezer still? Probably not, right? What you did to those wings was sinful. What are you talking about? I actually thought I'd done a pretty good job until I saw you put your plate down and realize what wings are supposed to look like after people eat them. Every time I see that absolutely demolish those wings meme, it makes me laugh because because I'm like, yeah, what's the problem? We got the good bit. It's you, dog. No. No, I want ice cream Sammy's. You should get one. You should get one delivered to you. Treat yourself. It's Wednesday, it's the middle of the week. You think you're gonna be able to survive the rest of the week without a silly little treat? I don't know about that. If it makes you feel any better about those wings, I'm exactly the same with strawberries as well. Where I don't eat too close to the stem. I don't know why. Oh, what's wrong with me? I'm afraid of getting poisoned. I was talking to my friend about how, like, the worse I am, like, mentally, just in general, the funnier shit I do without realizing. And I think that famous strawberry poisonings. I think that, like, the chicken wing thing was one of them. Because, like, I'm an alleged hypochondriac. I don't think that's true. Apart from, like, the obsessive washing hands and overcooking things to oblivion because I'm afraid of being poisoned, and it's fine. It doesn't matter. We have gone through a lot of soap lately. It's becoming a problem. I don't remember where I was going with that. Oh, yeah, I just think it's funny. Because, like, I never realize what I'm doing until afterwards, and then someone's like, you realize that's insane, right? I'm just like, no. And it's always the there's a scene in Always Sunny where Charlie's mum, like, starts flicking light switches, in, like, in sets of three. Because she's like, if I don't do it, then Charlie will die. And it's hilarious because blah, 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 you know, haha, silly woman. And then, silly woman, as in that's what they say. And then Charlie immediately starts doing it because he's like, well, I've not died yet. And I feel like I accidentally do shit like that all the time. And I have to actively stop. Like, someone's mum was telling me about how, telling them about how if you take tablets and you don't drink enough water, your blood dries up and then, like, you die. And obviously that's ridiculous, right? Like, that's not how tablets work. But every time I take a tablet now, I'm like, oh, I'm feeling a bit dry, you know? I can feel it absorbing my blood. And obviously that's not what happens. That's not what happens, but I'm afraid of it now. I'm a grown-ass adult, and I'm afraid of my blood drying up whenever I take a tablet. And that's saying something. I take four every morning. Maybe more. I don't remember. So, yeah. Always remember to drink a lot of water. And then I read somewhere that if you drink too much water with your tablet, then it can, like, go through your system too much, so you only need to drink how much water you need, rather than too much water. And then that made me panic more, because I'm like, oh my god, what if... Ah! Ah! So anyway, this is what my life is like. I've been doing, you know, I've been living. We good. I'm a big fan of the... that, where... Mugen Slay. I'm a big fan of that emote. That's a good one.
Dino Snore. Dino Snore. Oh.
One thing I really do appreciate about Powerwash is that even though you get some of like the shittest room layouts just so that they can give you like tedious stuff to do. God, it's satisfying. God, it's satisfying. More. I kind of want to play Wandering Village again. I only like gave it one session. And like, to be honest with you, I kind of feel like I've like played enough of it, but I've been kind of itching to go back. Because I don't think I did particularly well. But I also didn't really know what else I was supposed to do. But it was nice. Also, what's really fun is Despot's game, which I streamed a little bit of, but I'm like 80% sure it was like mining Bitcoin on my computer. Because it was at 100% CPU and GPU usage. And it's like a 2D game with stick men and text. So I was like, nah, something's going on here. I think it might just be like poorly optimized. But I feel like an RTX 4080 shouldn't be at 100% usage on a game entirely made of 2D assets. And it's like, I think it's like 400 megabytes in size. Like, it's not doing that much behind the scenes. You can't tell me that it is. And if it is, why? Explain this to me.
Describe him to me.
Me and my friends are going to do, like, a little bit of a movie night soon. And I'm really excited for that. Just because, like, I'm tired of people making references to stuff and me not getting I feel so left out. That's it. Then tweet. Oh, I can't describe how, but this sounds like Welcome to the Black Parade. I hear it. Thank you. I appreciate you. Ooh! Yeah. I'm cleaning the house. I literally want to be power washed so bad. I know it would take off all of my skin, but that's fine. It's a small price to pay for love. Would you do anything for love? I would. And in this case, love is being power washed. Until your skin becomes slough. And your bones harden. And you fall into a deep, dark hole. Forever. With nothing to prove your existence of before, except a mysterious police file that for some reason has a warning label on it that says, do not read. What? Oof, I got cut by a power washer once. Just a small cut on my hand, but it hurt like hell. Yeah. Yeah, I also have had a power washing related cut when I was younger. Which, to be fair, maybe because I was like so young, it might have hurt more in my head, but like, Jesus Christ, I remember it hurt so much, and it was one of those like really brutal cuts where like it takes a chunk of skin away. Sorry about anyone that's listening to this and doesn't like it. Like, you know, it takes a chunk of skin away and then you see it and then it starts bleeding. Like, it takes a second. Oh, I hate it.
Walk. Walk.
Can't believe we're at 95%. Time really flies when you're having fun.
Time really flies when you're chewing gum. Or so I'm told. Duke Nukem.
They should make Duke Nukem. Yeah, that's it. That's all. They should make Duke Nukem. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk.
It's time to kick gum and chew ass. And I'm all out of ass.
Don't forget to like and retweet. If it's your turn to kick gum and chew ass.
Leave your answers in the comments below. I'll pick my favorites in the next episode of Yai.
Speaking of binge watching YouTube content that's objectively probably not that good, I have been watching. I'm like a big video essay person. I love a good long video essay. And you know, I kind of run out of stuff sometimes. That's fine. It happens, you know? And usually when that happens, oh, so put the fucking dogs away, bro. I go and find something to watch. And usually, like, I'll watch basically anything if it's, like, even remotely my interest. It doesn't have to be good, I'll just watch it. And then, like, maybe if that person makes something good or honestly passable, I will binge watch the whole thing. Like, the whole channels, like, contents and stuff. And that's fine. That's great. That's cool. That's cool, 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 cool. My latest obsession has been, a food theory. Matt Pat's, a food channel. And honestly, I've been loving it. I've actually been loving it. It's, I'm not proud of it. I actually avoided game theory back in the day. When it was, like, really, really popular. I don't know if it still is. But it's good. It's interesting. It's self-referential. It's funny. It's, you know, based in fact. It's like, I feel like calling it theory is a little bit misleading because it's like actual science. But like, again, I've never seen game theory, so I don't actually know. I always assumed it was just, like, taking an insane idea and sort of running with it. The only thing I know about game theory is that they, like, pioneered Sans is Ness. Like, Sans Undertale is Ness Earthbound. Which is obviously insane, but I don't know, maybe it's true. Because, like, they don't do stuff like that in food theory. They don't say, like, oh, McDonald's fries are actually made out of chicken nuggets. It's, like, genuinely, like, debunking, like, oh, why people are doing this diet and why that's silly. It's just very interesting and very informative. I do feel a little bit like a fake science lover watching it, you know? Like, real like, Rick and Morty fan vibes. Like, because it's always like, oh, people say this, well, actually, it's this. And, like, it's, like, those types of, like, useless knowledge things that annoying people are like. And, unfortunately, I am annoying people. I am. As much as I try to not be, I think I might be one of those pseudo-intellectuals. And that is a very humbling realization to have. Because, like, let's be real, like, yeah. Is peanut butter actually liquid? No. I mean, like, yes, technically, but no. Ba-ba-ba-ba. It's nice to not get clickbaited. You know, I think my previous, like, phase was Linus Tech Tips, but I'm kind of over it now. Like, I think that LTT has definitely, like, wormed its way into, like, my daily vernacular, my, like, you know, when they upload a new video that I'm interested in, I'll always watch it. I'll always watch, like, WAN Show when they publish it on YouTube. And, like, I subscribe to, like, Tech Quickie and Game Quickie, or whatever it's called, Short Circuit. Those are all cool. But, like, I'm kind of over the actual, like, LTT, like, video binge which I was doing, where I would just, like, watch reviews for, like, GPUs from 10 years ago, just because I thought it was interesting. Move over, Linus Sebastian. Matthew Patrick is in town. And he's telling me about McDonald's and how they make most of their money from real estate as opposed to food. For some reason, I feel like using the more powerful jet wash like I am now is using more battery in my controller. Which is, again, another one of those completely insane, like, insane things that doesn't make any sense, but I feel it. I'm getting worried about it. And I know that's not true. That can't be true. But my controller is, like, so low on battery that it's not vibrating anymore. So I'll have to plug it in at some point. But it's fine. Ever. Fuck it, I'll do it now. I'm gonna take my batteries out, because I get paranoid about having stuff with batteries that aren't rechargeable plugged in. Just in case one day, you know? Also, look at my cable. I don't know if you can see it, but it, like kind of lights up. And it, like, changes color. It's, like, it's very, very inefficient. But I like it. And we're back with vibration. I'm breaking up good vibrations. I don't want to claim the dinosaur. He deserves to be a mucky boy. Fucking Elder Scrolls sounding ass. Although, I don't think Elder Scrolls was on the PlayStation 1. I am gonna check, though. No, this is from Jade Cocoon, which I've never heard of. Shout out to all my Jade Cocoon fans out there. Bum 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 bum. It starts with you. One thing, I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. Jade Cocoon? Wait, you know Jade Cocoon? What's it about? What is it? What is it? Who up Jade and they cocoon right now? Da-da-da-da. Man, Kiri Kip Bites. What? What? What happened? Or are you describing someone? Are you describing someone as the man that Kiri Kip Bites? No, that doesn't make any sense. No, no. Why? What did Kip bite? Can confirm, Kip does bite. Ba-ba-ba. But hey, that's just a bite. A Kip bite. Thanks for watching. Monster Collector JRPG. Ooh, Monster Collectors. Monster... Fuck, I used to love Monster Rancher on the Game Boy Advance. I know that there was a PS1 version of it, but, like, fuck that. I had a copy of Pokemon... So the label said Pokemon Red 2. Because I got it from a bootleg market, and it was just Monster Rancher. And to this day, in my head, Pokemon Red 2 is a game that exists, even though it's just Monster Rancher. But yeah, also hi D-Man, I realize I didn't say hello, how are you doing? Thank you for swinging by. There was a new Monster Rancher recently, wasn't there? Or am I wrong about that? I think it was digital only? Can't wait for Dragon Quest Monsters. Ooh, that looks really good. That looks really, really good. That's the one that got, like, a proper trailer at the, like, Summer Games Fest thing recently. Just re-released in HD. Okay. Interesting. Maybe I'll play it then. Honestly, the fact that it's just a remaster is, honestly... There was a Kaiju Monster Rancher game? Really? Ba, ba, ba. Ba, 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 ba. I don't want to play Monster Rancher. Monster Rancher re-release is a Monster Rancher half package. Wait, really? Jake Cocoon had a mechanic where you fuse monsters. Oh, that's good. I'm a big fan of that. It's a half package? How come it's a half package? Oh! It's a one and two pack. That makes way more sense. Sorry for being stupid. It would take the texture of one and slap it on the model of another and then blend their sets. That's so cool! It's fun to play games with Tortle. I'm used to it. The idea of putting, like, textures from one onto another is very cool. And it's also very PS1. Like, I know this isn't, but it sounds like Drakengard. No, this is Klonoa. Klonoa was amazing. Fight. Should have seen Tortle last night. Why? What happened? What did I miss? What were you guys playing? Watch his VOD when you get the chance. You gonna leave me on a cliffhanger? Maybe I will. We were playing 7 Days to Die. That's crazy! I was playing 7 Days to Die the other day with my friend Pisces. We had a really good time. I hope we get to play again soon. Bum, 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 bum. We only played for a couple of hours because we started quite late, but it was good. I had a good time. I should probably start streaming, like, multiplayer games that I'm playing with people. A game on warrior difficulty and had our first blood moon. I didn't like this is new to me. What blood moon? I think I might be playing on easy. Every 7 days. Ah. So you've got 7 days to blood moon, I guess you could say. Don't waste the blood moon. So many don't waste the blood moon. Huge horde of zombies. Ah. Oh, shit. I always expect nighttime to be a lot scarier in 7 Days to Die, but I think I've never actually gone out at night. I've just been like, and hid. So that might be why. Give me ladder. You won't be able to hide in the Blood Moon. No? Zombies find a way. Zombies, find a way. Haven't seen Jurassic Park either. That's a lie, I have actually seen Jurassic Park. I watched it with my first long-term girlfriend the day I broke up with her. That's a memory I've got, unfortunately. God, tired, man. Hey, wanna watch a movie? Also, I'm breaking up with you. Yeah! I mean, basically. So, basically, I'm baby? I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to be mean. I'm nice. Dating me is actually fun and normal. And you can trust me. Lie. Yeah, no, that's fair. Nah, that's fair. I'm trying to find the stuff that I've not cleaned properly yet. Aha! Aha! Last night was a blast, and that's why you should watch Turtles World. Okay, I will. You've convinced me. You've effectively shilled. And I will watch it. I say as soon as I finished my watch through of hashtag not shilling. I wish you'd clean like this in Vampire's Bloodlines. Oh god, me too. Fuck yeah. Honestly, I think that I wish I was playing VTM right now. I've not been able to stop thinking about it. Also, hi Ali, how are you? Every game needs a clean minigame. There's something that comes to mind is Bully, or Canis Canem Edit, as it's called over here. You know the Rockstar game set in the school? I had Sports Day. I had Sports Day. Oh, fuck yeah, I forget you work in a school. I'm sorry for your loss. Brick wall top? Where's the love for the brick wall bottom? Oh, chimney breasts. Do you have to do anything on the sports day? Is it hot today? I don't understand how things work. I mean, like, I don't know if you can tell just by like looking at me, but I'm not the sportiest of people, and I was not in school. Eep. Did I set up an eep command? Kids fell over in races. I had to not laugh because the teacher is rooted unethical. You should conduct experiments on them. Which one can survive the longest fall? Don't do that. And if you do that, tell me the results, but like not actually, you know. Are you wall lamps? No, you're ceiling. Wall lamp. Are you a wall lamp? What wall in the lamp right now? They had me on shop put duty, so I was slinging balls all day. Just another Wednesday. Who up slinging their balls right now? Oh, nice. And you can see my Among Us. Very cool. I've done been slunging my balls. My balls have been slung from time to time. I'd be lying if I said that I've not slung balls every now and again. if I've not been meeting. Hardy, Daytona, and Shinra Hauler. Alright, so like, here's the thing. I've not played Final Fantasy VII. But that's what we're doing now. So anyone who likes Final Fantasy VII Remake in particular, you know, enjoy the references. We're in a car dealership, I guess. We're in the Shinra Corporation. We got a dirty bike. We got a truck. The car. But isn't this nice? Isn't this very Final Fantasy-esque? Do you feel like you really are Cloud Strife right now? Who's Reeve Toosty? Ah, SA 37, Sonic Adventure 37? Yeah, you got damn right. I can't believe they made 37 Sonic Adventure games. Not that angsty. Yeah, you are. Actually, no, that's a lie. You might be one of the least angsty peoples I know. Unlike me. Yeah. When is Final Fantasy VII Remake coming to Xbox? I guess I could just play it on PC at this point, right? I forget that sometimes. I forget that I have a PC, despite, you know, currently being on it. Oh, clean. Just get a PS5. It's not that simple, unfortunately. Who has the money? Raising a fundraiser. So beginning a fundraiser to get a PS5. Zero people will donate. I do. Alright. Put it on throne. I'll buy it for you. Bet. Can you imagine if I like stopped right now and added a PS5 to my throne? No. Yeah, didn't think so. That would be insane. Did the maid costume come in yet? Actually, I think it's due to come in next week. I think I finally received shipping details for it. I can't believe how long it's taken. So, be ready for that. I hope it fits. I haven't decided yet if I'm doing a stream in it or not. I know, didn't someone buy that like 2 weeks ago? Yeah, ages ago. It was, I don't even remember why. It was just like kind of out of nowhere, wasn't it? Like, I knew it was gonna take a while because like they said on the website it'd take ages, but like, it's taken a long time. But like, I've got like tracking on my like shop app now, so. Was in your throne, I saw it on sale. Yeah, because you pointed it out in chat, and then someone immediately bought it. Thanks for that. I've not decided if I'm going to do a stream in it or not. It depends if it fits properly. And, you know, I don't know, man. Maybe what I should do is save it for the 24-hour stream, because, as I've mentioned, I plan on doing a 24-hour stream, if possible. Someone has told me that I should do a subathon instead of just a straight up 24-hour stream, because like my plan was to just stream for 24 hours and not be like asking for subs or whatever, just because I think it would be funny to stream for 24 hours, but apparently that might be a good idea. I don't know. And then like what, the time gets extended for every sub you get or whatever, and then that way if it's a flop stream, then I don't have to just stream to no one for 24 hours, which might be a good point. And then maybe I could set a goal or a redeem or something that's like, go put on the maid outfit. Better to do 24-hour streams when you're young like you. I'm so young, dumb, and full of ambition. 24 is a lot. Oh yeah, definitely. Like, it's an insane amount of time. But don't forget the wheel. I will not forget the wheel. Kyle suggested that I get a wheel and put a bunch of demos on it, and I think that's a really good idea. And then, like, I spin the wheel to decide what I do. It's clever. I'm trying to make, like, a schedule before I commit to it, though. Just in case, you know. Because, like, on some days, even though I only stream for, like, 3-4 hours, I don't have anything to do. Like, I'm not in the mood to do anything in the moment, and I've not planned it. So I just kind of end up doing nothing. Or, more accurately, playing Minecraft, which I'm fine with. So, when I do a potential 24-hour stream, I want to kind of have all of the hours, like, planned out. And I need to make sure that I don't start drinking too early, otherwise I'll get sleepy. Are you done? Rear fender? I don't really understand cars. But yeah, kind of the idea behind doing a 24-hour stream is, like, because it's a lot, you know? Like, I'm hoping that the hype, like, you know, by doing something a little bit different slash insane, it might garner some attention. But maybe not. Who knows? Who knows? And, like, worst case scenario is I fall asleep at my desk and someone has to come in and, like, stop my stream. Which is fine. Or I just fucking stream at my desk. I fall asleep, I wake up. If the stream is still going, then fuck it. What's a win? Make a loud command for mods. What, to wake me up? To be fair, actually, I don't really, like, most of my mods don't really, they're, like, usually quite busy, got their own stuff going on, so I might have to make, like, new VIPs and new mods at some point. I keep meaning to make Lucy a mod, because I think Lucy is probably here. Kira doesn't believe in mods. This is true, I don't believe in mods. I'm waiting till marriage. Yeah, because, like, I think Lucy is probably in my streams the most, so I should probably make her a mod or a VIP or something. I don't know. Overwatch 2 coming to Steam next month. Yeah, I saw that. Weird. Although I did see that, as with every piece of Overwatch news that came in the wake of some bad news, I don't remember what it was, it's something to do with the Overwatch League, and something scummy that happened with that, I didn't even bother reading it. I saw Overwatch news and I went, okay, what have they done? Looked it up and went, yeah, fucking thought so. I wish I was into Overwatch. I really do. I gain no pleasure in not liking things, you know? It's so boring not liking stuff. It's so much fun when someone says, hey, I like doing this, and you can go, yeah, that's great. Good for you. I would like to try that also. Overwatch is just so, it's just like the League of Legends type thing. Like, it's the exact same audience to me. Everyone I know who's played Overwatch, like, remotely seriously, has been so unbelievably toxic. And I can't do that. Again, I don't get how people can get mad at games. It's not my thing. Pleasure in not liking things. Honestly, good for you. As is your right. I think hating on stuff can be fun sometimes. Like being a smug, sassy ass. Yeah, I know you do. I know you do. It's not a lot I don't like you. I think the thing is, liking things is easy, right? Because, like I'd say my default state is liking something. Ah, weird. I missed this. Anything I don't like are turtles.
Oh, turtles.
How could you not like turtles? And Starfield. You don't like Starfield? Is Starfield out yet? No, it's not out yet. Right? Like, I'm losing my mind. Of course it's not out yet. Gaslit me for a second there. I was like, wait. What? Cap panel. Trying to trigger turtle. Doesn't seem to be working. I just don't think he cares that much about you, I'm sorry. He's being a good turtle and working. Oh, that's no fun. He doesn't, I don't blame him. Scorpion Sentinel? Reeve tells me you're quite the shot. I don't... No, that's not... I need to do some work, I think. I feel like I'm always working.
Behold, the Scorpion Sentinel.
Hmm. I assume this is very impressive for fans. You don't need Battle.net for Overwatch 2? That's actually shocking, you don't? So you told Jakiru? Yeah, you did. Yeah. Ah, not needing a Battle.net account is kind of game-changing. I genuinely think it should be, like, Steam policy to not allow making you sign into stuff. I'm sick of having to give my data over to random companies. Like, Exoprimal, you have to make a Capcom account. Like, it stops you dead on when you try to play the game. It's like, you have to make a Capcom account, sorry. And, like, it makes you, like, do it on your phone whilst you're sitting on the menu and doesn't let you play. And I just think that's... I think that's insane. How is that game, by the way? It's fine. It's fine. I wouldn't have played it if it wasn't on Game Pass. It was enjoyable. Is it like EDF? Yeah, it's a bit like Earth Defense Force. It's got a lot less soul. It's a lot less cool. It's very Capcom. It's very Capcom. But, like, it's a bit soulless. The shitty character writing is probably one of my favorite things about it. Gunplay feels nice, it's good, it does the kind of like a Destiny thing where it fucks you around for a bit. Gotta drive home, no problems, that will drive safe. Tifa Lockhart. Damn. Tifa be texting me? I thought she was busy at the Italian Senate or whatever it was called. It was a good video. Tifa send boot pick. Tifa send Bob send Virgin. Tifa, I am home alone. Tifa, please. Tifa, I have always loved you. Damn, hey Dagger, that's great. Oh, sorry that happened. Tifa, I'm damn bad. Tifa. Tifa, I've broken both of my arms and I desperately need help. Tifa, please. Tifa. Tifa, my mum says that you can sleep in my room tonight. Is that? Yeah, there it is. I assume this is like a battle arena from the game. Can you like clean most of the stuff and come back to it? Yeah, you can do anything. You can do any amount and then just come back to it. It like saves, I think, every like 10 seconds or something absurd. You just quit and come back and it's done. That's normally what I do if I get too tired, to be honest with you. The next level is power washing Tifa Lockhart. Oh, Exoprimal also has a sexy robot lady as well. Sent tweet. Power the shit out of Tifa. Interesting. I mean, same, but... Fucking soul! Yeah. Buy an Exoprimal? Yeah. It's really funny, like, she came up on screen and immediately Chester looked at me and was like, don't. And I was like, what? I didn't say anything. But I think he knew. He knew. Oh, clean. Like, with all due respect, cleaning these, like, intricate little robots and bikes and stuff fucking suck in this game. Hey, Bolton installing. Nice. Enjoy. Enjoy Exoprimal. I think I've played enough of it, to be honest with you, but... We also outfitted it with close-range EM field and self-repair functionality. You're playing with me. Maybe. Actually. It might be fun. I only played it alone. So it might be fun. I don't know if it's cross-platform. I don't know if this, I don't know what you've got it on. I assume PC. I didn't get it on Steam. That's so sad. I'll wait for a sale if I ever do get it. Yeah, I mean, again, it's on Game Pass, if you've got Game Pass, but also having another subscription is a whole thing, so... I'm like, who wants that? And then you don't own it, and no. Definitely not worth the full asking price of the game. Just not enough to it, and it's like so shameless in... I don't play enough games to make Game Pass worth it. I'd rather wait for a Steam sale and buy it. Yeah, no, that's fair. Honestly, my Game Pass subscription is made like worth it just by playing Powerwash every week. Like, I honestly feel like I should own Powerwash Simulator, but I don't. Maybe once I've properly done all of Powerwash, I should just buy it out of respect. Well, Powerwash, I spent $10 on it. Yeah, that's the thing, because it's not an expensive game, is it? I wish this fucking freak would hold still. $25 right now? What the fuck? I mean, I've definitely gotten more than $25 worth of, like, content out of it, but it's not the point, you know? No, I guess that kind of should be the point. I don't know. Oh no, I don't like paying too much money for stuff. $8 for SpongeBob. Yeah, I think it was like £4 when I bought SpongeBob, but because like you get like a discount on DLC when you've got Game Pass, and I actually did buy the SpongeBob. I bought the sponge because I was so excited for it. A small price to pay for Bobbler Sponge. BRB, no props. Enjoy. Time for some winter. I mean, I apparently have 0 followers, which is cool. As I've let me start from the top, because I realized what I was thinking, and then I started speaking out loud halfway mid-sentence. Okay, so, I got, like, follower bot-raided a little while ago, and, you know, I was like, oh, that's a shame, because it's kind of, like, taken away that milestone from me, and they're all, like, fake followers, so they're gonna get, like, gradually deleted over time. And that's what's been happening, obviously. Ah, there we go. It's back. It's now given me my actual followers. But, like, unfortunately, no, I don't remember what I was saying. Yes, I do. Fucking hell, sorry. So Twitch has, like, a thing in place where it kind of does, like, waves of bans for bots. So, like, I went from 87 followers or whatever it was that I had to the 290 followers that I gained from the bots, and then it's been, like, going down gradually since. And it seems to have, like, settled at 137 now, which is where we're at now, but I keep expecting it to go back down again, because, like, you know, because, like, I know that that's not the number of real followers I've got, right? And I just got a notification saying, your follower goal of 100 followers is now complete. And, like, I don't know where that's come from, because I technically hit that ages ago, because of the bot raid. So, I don't know, Dutch. Yeah. God, I keep thinking of when I went to see Papa Roach and they fucking played that. And then, like, you know, they had that, like, riff going on over and over and over and over again. Whilst they were, like, talking about how grateful they are for, like, everyone that showed up. And how, like, fucking insane they are. And how they want to see, like, the biggest mosh pit in the world. And they want people to die. And it was kind of crazy. Because, like, it was just a bit embarrassing, to be perfectly blunt with you. I haven't been to a gig that I've, like, properly enjoyed in a while. I don't know what it is. That's the good shit. feel like I shouldn't be washing these things. I don't know why they feel evil. I don't really know the lore of Final Fantasy VII, but this thing feels evil. Is nice. I imagine Reef Hedgie some feel good tripe about his plans for the future, didn't he? No man, I've not been reading these. I've been reading chat mostly, so, you know. Soz baby cakes. I'm not reading all of that. Good for you, or sorry that happened. I assume it's like politics of Final Fantasy VII, which, quite frankly, I shrimply do not give a damn. He's looking nice and clean though, isn't he? He may be used for evil. Oh, but he's so cute. He'll be so cute and clean whilst he does it. What is this? This is so familiar. No, a Lundra 2. I've never heard of that. But, fuck's hard. Like, how are you supposed to clean these bits without just basically flailing like this? Because, yeah. Do I have metal? I bet this song would be very impactful if I'd, like, ever heard of... This is from Pokemon Racing! Mind. Sorry I doubted you, Pokemon Racing. Why does this sound so sad if it's from fucking Chocobo Racing? Cool. Really excited. I'm going to a like a party type thing this weekend, and there's going to be like basically free food and drink, and I'm very excited for that. Just, I don't know, I've been very, very plan-y recently. I've been wanting to kind of do more with myself, so it's been exciting being like invited to stuff left and right. It's been a very busy month. I think like it's a lot of people's birthdays, it's a lot of people's whatchamajig, like, I don't know, summer dues. A lot of people like just have more energy because it's summer, which is weird because I've always been the complete opposite. I do not thrive when it's warm. So it's been a bit difficult, I won't lie. But I've just been like, I don't know, I've been feeling very loved from all of the invites I've been getting for stuff, and that's been really nice. Going to this like party thing on Saturday, and then the week after I'm going to like a cocktail bar. Before like an actual party, which I'm very excited about. If you look at my girlfriend, he's the only one that I have. If you look at my girlfriend, I'm everything. Been a while since we last spoke. Sorry, I don't actually know the lyrics to that song, nor can I sing. So, you know. Clean. Who's a sparkly little Mac? You are. It's really annoying because, like, I'm struggling to find, like, dirt. And I can press, like, the button that highlights it, which is great. But then I clean all I can see, and then sometimes the thing doesn't ding clean. And then I'm like, oh, there it is. I don't know, Dutch. I don't know, Dutch. I wonder, like, how many things Undertale can be ported to. I don't know why this has suddenly struck my mind, but just, like, I wonder if you can port Undertale to, like, the PS1. Like, part of me is like, I don't see why not. It's kind of got the aesthetic for it. It's got the low file size. Like, it could fit on a disc, right? Maybe it couldn't fit on a PS1 disc, but it could fit on a PS2 disc. Because PS1s were CDs, aren't they? Not DVDs. This is nice. Ding. One of my, like, favourite sayings of all time is, be kind, rewind, and I don't know why, because I never used to rent, like, tapes, never used to rent VHS tapes, I owned all of my own, so no one, you know, no one ever said be kind, rewind. But yeah, I don't know, I like it. it fills me with nostalgia, despite probably not really having the nostalgia necessary.
Ooh.
You go over there. Sick of you. Oh, this goes hard. Feel free to screenshot. Why am I so hungry? I have to find out where this is from. It goes too hard to ignore. From Gran Turismo 2? Amazing. God, the PS1 had some bangers. In just, like, the places you would not expect them to be. My friend told me about how I used to bother her by messaging so much, and then one day I stopped and realized that when I'd stopped she missed me and was like happy when I started messaging again, and like I feel like I've accidentally given my friend I feel like I've accidentally given my friend, like, Stockholm Syndrome. Like, forced them to talk to me so much that now that whenever I don't talk to them, they miss me. And I'm just like, ah. Which is, you know, a normal thing to worry about. I know. Gran Turismo go hard. That's the good shit. That it? Is the playlist over? Yeah, the playlist is over. I mean, I can't. Ah, go on. I'll do it again. I'll do a different one. GTA soundtrack is the best. GTA soundtrack is really good. Honestly, the thing that makes me think the most about the GTA soundtrack, specifically like Vice City in San Andreas, is like the radio, which obviously isn't something I can play on stream because it's just like regular music, but man, is it iconic. Like, Video Kill the Radio Star is like permanently associated with GTA Vice City in my head. That is not what this song is, but God, make me think of it. It is evocative of it. When I polish death robot. Robot that kills you instantly. This is from Ridge Racer. Ridge Racer! Ridge Racer. Leg gripper. What I call my hands. When someone tells a good joke. Am I right? What the fuck am I on about? This almost sounds Danganronpa-ish. I can't put my finger on it, though. Like, it's still Ridge Racer, but... oh, no. Very Danganronpa-ish. Oh, yeah, we 99% clean up in this bitch. These, like, PlayStation soundtracks seem to, like, really, like, cave music. I don't know how to describe it. Hey, Cryptid, how's it going? Thanks for swinging by. Oh my god, this is gonna sound insane. I've just, like, I've been worrying for the past, like, week or so that when I've been streaming, I've been going like that with my head and just, like, getting, like, proper little neck. I realized that my chair wasn't, like, leaning back properly, and I've only just come to this realization after fucking how long. Anyway, how have you been doing? Come on, baby girl. Come on, look at me. Come on, look at me. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, no. Yeah. All right, fine. I'll come over there myself.
Oh yes, Mark 98, gamer pose.
I had a pretty good day. Set my VR headset again. That's so cool. What are you playing, or what are you planning on playing, if you've not played anything yet? I mean, like the obvious one. It's got to be Beat Saber, right? I don't know how people play Beat Saber without custom music. Like, I realize that sounds mean to specifically the Beat Saber devs, right? Because, you know, they like license the songs. But like, I don't know, there's just something so much more enjoyable about like custom meme songs in Beat Saber that
fan belts.
Yeah, like, as a joke, I tried to do, like, the entire Shrek movie on Beat Saber, and obviously that's, like, way too much to do. You know, it's an hour and a half. But fuck, was it fun to try. I like custom levels so much more. The joy of downloading the easy song you like and you're floored by the hardest thing. Exactly. Leg grippers. Who up legging they grip right now? Where's that? There it is. Shoulders. Especially because, like, you download something like Megalovania, which you expect to be incredibly difficult. And it's, like, not that hard, really. I mean, like, you know, I'm not going to play on Super Expert. Who do you think I am? But... Where's the dirt?
Show me the dirt.
Field generator hood, leg hinge lowers. Easy. Look at that. I'm on top of it, mate. I'm a savage. Power wash size, average. Claw wrists. Come on, baby girl, look at me. Yeah, that's good. Field generator hood. PlayStation. This machine has never been cleaner. This machine has never been cleaner. You're so right. Now, what is a field generator hood? Hood? Head? Hood? Field generator? No. Tail? Back plate? Abdomen. Abdomen. Leg. Leg. Balls. Front wheel. Underbelly. Oh, don't make me highlight it. Iframe. Me when I play Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and I get my iframes. Tail that shoots lasers. Are you a field generator? Yeah! I knew I'd figure it out. I'm a goddamn genius. I'm a goddamn genius. Also, this looks like Dinklebot. This looks like a 343 Guilty Spark. Very nice. Very nice. Alright, now I get to do Teeth at 7th Heaven. Hello. I don't know if I'll be able to do all of this tonight. If it's like an entire room, these things normally take fucking ages. I wish it would give me all of them. Is this a bar? I've not played Final Fantasy VII. Pizza? Is this a subtle reference to Tifa Lockhart's Italian heritage? Can't believe Tifa Lockhart is sending me DMs. Honestly, I've got so many bitches. Just insane. Even the fictional baddies are coming for me now. Which shouldn't surprise anyone, frankly. I mean, look at me. God. Juice box. Me when I clean the juice box. Oh, button that flashbangs you. Button that I accidentally pressed for the second time in a row because I'm so used to pressing it. I've really gone and covered the entire interior under a 2-inch layer of grime. Who'd be doing this? Who's doing this? Whomstead of. There is a... imposter. One more. You were drawing a dick for some reason. I would never. You like him? Isn't he sweet? Isn't he milk-like? I love him 10 out of 10. I'm glad you do. Games! Neon sign clear. I miss Milk a Mod. I miss D-Man. I always think it would be really funny to set up commands that, like, auto-ban people. Whenever they try to do something on my stream that is, like, normal on Kip's stream. Just because I think it'd be funny. But, like, you know. I don't think people would find it that funny, unfortunately. And that's the sadness of it all. Miss Tortle. I hope he drives safe. You know? I hope he drives safe. Look at that, so clean, so beautiful. See, this is great and all, but like, then you like increase the cone of it. And then when you actually go look over it, you realize that you've left a bunch of, like, little marks. So just going yellow is the way to go, even though it takes fucking ages. Found a channel recently where that automatically times you out for an increase of time. That's really funny. Fuck, I should do stuff like that. I don't know what it is, but whenever, like, I'm not in on the joke when I join someone else's channel and I get, like, timed out for something that I assume is, like, supposed to be funny, I always feel a little bit, like, put off. I don't know if that's just me. So, like, I don't want people to feel like that. Oh. There we go. But, like, the idea of, like, constantly banning people is just, it's too funny, you know? Like, I'm sure if I'd played Final Fantasy VII, this would look very impressive, this room. All of the details. Like, oh, whoa, this is the golden pinball machine! With the cowboys! Banning people like a TF2 server admin for the bit. like a roleplay server mod. So, we're actually... Everybody here has to pretend to be a cowboy, and if you speak like you're not a cowboy, then I'll ban you. Sorry, guys. Every time someone, like, donates bits or anything, I have to be like, look, I'm sorry. Cowboy Country doesn't have bits, so you're banned. Oh, room that blinds you when you accidentally press left on the D-pad. Pizza oven that probably should be cleaner than it is, regardless of how much grime there is. I kind of want to listen to the Magnus Archives again. Like, I don't know why. I'm not much of, like, a re-listener, re-watcher person. And, like, I always find myself kind of, like, not paying attention anymore. But I've been craving it, you know? I've been craving those feelings again. I tell you what, it is insane the things that people will do when they've got a crush on someone. And, like, by people, I'm talking about me. Like, I was dating this guy for a little while. And he offhandedly mentioned liking Adele. So I listened to Adele's, like, newest album on loop, just so I could, like, get to know it. And then another person mentioned that they really, really like Glee. And it's, like, their like, comfort show. So I watched, like, an entire season of Glee, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried whilst I was watching it, because, like, I was in a really bad place and very emotional, this whole thing. I would never have done that before. And, like, I only did those things because I was down bad. It was down horrendous. I'd like to think that nowadays I'm a bit more screwed on, but you never know. Let's clean the pizza under the pasta under the box. Oh, very nice. Oh. Fucking filthy. I'm trying to think of, like, other things I did when I, like, was into someone. I was talking in the Discord earlier about how the last Tinder date I went on, which was, like, years ago, I met someone, and, like, so we went to the theatre together and saw some, like, amateur play. It was fine. It was shit, to be honest. I think we both kind of thought it was shit. And we got out at, like, 11, and I was like, hey, you want to go to, like, a bar or something? And she was like, I want to go to a bookshop. And I was like, it's 11 o'clock. There's nowhere. Like, it's 11 o'clock on a, like, Wednesday. There's no way there's going to be a bookshop open, but we can try find one. And she got, like, really sulky with me and didn't want to, like, go to, like, a bar or, you know, anywhere just to, like, hang out, like, a park or something. And that was, like, fair enough. I was a bit like, well, you know, date to date. You know, I had a nice time, but you don't have to stay. It's late, you know? And, like, that was great. Except she got proper sulky because she wanted to go to a bookshop. And she was like, yeah, I came from Canada because I wanted to, like, you know, I thought you guys were supposed to be, like, more sophisticated and stuff, but, like, everything's been a disappointment so far. And I was, like, I was so offended. She was so mean for no reason, and I don't know why. I mean, you know, I wasn't that offended. I was like, oh, okay, you know, I'm sorry you feel that way, enjoy the rest of your day, etc. But, like, I never texted her again. And I assume, you know, I don't know why I say that, like, I had control over that situation. She was clearly very unhappy. But I don't know, I just thought it was funny. My one experience with Tinder was installing the app, setting up my account. First got on there, used to be a friend from school, so I panicked and deleted it. That's hilarious. Although, I mean, like, did you deactivate your account, or did you just delete the app? Because, like, if you panicked, you know, you probably saw. Not to like, make you panic more, but I'm just saying. I actually used to really enjoy seeing people that I went to school with on Tinder. I don't know why. I think he asked me out once. But I was too dumb to... Wait, so you had, like, the perfect, like, rom-com opportunity to, like, rekindle that. Oh, cryptid! Was he a jock? This is just like Glee. I too wish to know if he was a jock.
Cheer, bruh. How's it going, bruh?
Nerdy just like me, but I heard from other friends that saw him occasionally that he got ripped, so I guess. I mean, or he could be a nerdy guy who's also ripped. I mean, I don't know anything about this person, so, you know. True picks, Kyle, down. Put it away. Put the claws away. You're not going to go to Austria. I actually don't know where Cryptid is from. But honestly, I don't know. Maybe you should give it a shot. Genuinely. I mean, I don't know. I don't know if you're actually currently looking, but if you are, maybe it's meant to be. La la la. Oh no! This is satisfying. This is very satisfying. Austria, but he might not even live here anymore. Haven't interacted for years. You should find out. Add him on, like, Facebook or something. I don't know if people still use Facebook. Is that a boomer thing? I'm taken by my partner and Chai Hi-Fi Rush. Honestly, that's fair. That's fair. I'm pro your partner and also Chai Hi-Fi Rush. I believe in Chai Hi-Fi Rush supremacy. Chai Fi Rush. Jet Grinder. You telling me to let Jet Grinder right now? Like, you don't even have the app. This is true. This is true. I have said this before. My friend was talking to me about how her friend lives with someone else and they share the same bed and they go to loads of events together, but they rent together and they do everything together, but they're like explicitly not dating apparently. Eggs and chips. It's Kip and Chester. No, I think Kip and Chester are explicitly dating. So I've heard. I might be wrong about that though. Correct me if I'm wrong, gamers. And like, I don't know, I just think it's strange. It feels very much like a Sappho and her friend type situation, because like they explicitly always say, oh yeah, we're just friends. And they never like talk about like whether or not they're actually queer, but you're wrong. I'm wrong? Oh. That's a shame. Oh well. So as always, next time. Seventh Heaven. Welcome. Welcome there. Welcome there, Tifa. Oh, why is the Buster Sword in here? Why is Cloud's Buster Sword in here? I mean, you know, it's cool. Why does Cloud have this sword? I don't know what the, like, in-universe reason for it is. He just has a big sword because he likes big swords or what? That's the cooler version of having a baseball bat behind the bar. Yeah. Might have been a teaser for the Final Fantasy VII DLC. This is the Final Fantasy VII DLC. A teaser for the Final Fantasy VII DLC in the Final Fantasy VII DLC. It's Tomb Raider. Nah, I finished that. I've been doing Final Fantasy VII stuff for a little while now. That's why I keep getting Tifa Lockhart blowing up my DMs. If your friends are gay, then sharing a bed makes and all makes sense. Yeah, definitely. It's just weird that they won't admit it. Like, they are both self-proclaimed straight. But, like, I don't know if they just, like, aren't ready to talk about it. But, like, they've, like, moved in together and share a bed. So I feel like, at that point, you know? Like, who are you fooling? Except maybe your parents? Or one wants a relationship, the other doesn't. Yeah. Like, again, that would be fine. But, like, they're kind of quite the tax man. Do you get taxed more if you're gay? Honestly, that wouldn't fucking surprise me. Hail it. I think I'm gonna go once I finish this, which is fine because I've got ages left to do this. You paid the slay tax. Oh, I paid the slay tax, alright. I don't know why I did that. God, I keep thinking about that, like... So in H&M have this like kind of like meshy, see-through black shirt that's got like roses on it. And I really, really want it, but it was 40 quid, so I didn't buy it when I saw it a couple of weeks ago, and I can't stop thinking about it now. It slayed so much cunt. It slayed so much pussy cunt. And now it's gone. And I can't find it online, and it's breaking my heart. Check online. Yeah, I've been checking basically all day today. It's worse as well, because my friend offered to buy it for me on the day, but I said no. And, like, I just... the thing is, I don't know how to describe it. Like, I can't even find a picture of it. And that's very sad. I guess I could go into a H&M in person. Draw it. Have you seen how good I am at drawing? I don't think that's a good idea. What is that? What is this? Barrett's Gatling gun? Ah. He's one of the members of the party, isn't he? The guy with the gun hand. Interesting. Very interesting. I forget, does Tifa and Aerith, do they have, like, weapons? I mean, I assume not, since I can't see them anywhere. I assume Tifa, like, punches or something. I don't know, she seems like she punches. I don't know why. I just get those vibes from her. And Aerith, I don't know, healer, maybe? Healer is the vibe I get from Aerith. She's very flowy, very, very Luna Freya from Final Fantasy XV. Why is the menu, like, so far down here? Is it, like, menu for children? Menu for ants? What is this? A center for ants? How can the children learn to read if they can't even fit inside the building?
He's absolutely right.
The building needs to be at least 3 times bigger than this. A Santa for ants, orange mocha frappuccino, a Santa for ants. You guys remember the YouTube channel Shmo Yoho? Yeah. Good times. Paste down my face, on my hair, on my shirt. She looks at me, and I'm looking at her. 1, 2, 3. Your life is your life. Somewhere there is light. The gods wait to delight in you. It beats the darkness. You are marvelous. Who's intending to be who? Your life is your life, the forms, the repetitions. Don't let it be pep into dank submission. You should get to the point where anyone else would quit. You're gonna get there and work hard. Just do it, nothing is impossible. Just do it, yesterday you said tomorrow. Just do it, don't let your dreams be dreams. The more often you do it, the more that there will be. I squirt toothpaste in my mouth. I start to brush. She's looking at me. I start to blush. Sometimes I feel like I feel that war between us. That war between me and Shia LaBeouf. Actual cannibal Shia LaBeouf. Running from your life from Shia LaBeouf. He's brandishing a knife, Shia LaBeouf. God. The Rob Cantor version of that is so good. Like the live action one. Fantastic. Fudging-tastic. Why did I say fudging? How old am I? Fuck. Thank you for coming to my TED talk. Thank you for coming to my TED swears. Weird the machine guns just like go in your hand. Tell me about Cloud, Tifa. Come on, baby girl. Stop blowing up my DMs. Tifa, send pics. I kind of expected to like learn more about Cloud there, not just like, oh yeah, he's helping. If you clean up his Buster Sword too, I'm sure it'd make his day. Yeah, totally. Girl. Does Cloud talk? Or is he a silent protagonist? I don't know why I'm asking. I guess I should just play it. It's like in Smash he talks. A little bit. When he like taunts and stuff. And like he makes a lot of like grunts and stuff, which is like, honestly, like he's more vocal than like Link, for example. He does only speak Japanese in Smash, though, which is kind of a pain. I mean, I guess there's nothing wrong with it, I just wish I knew what he was saying. Should just learn Japanese, really, shouldn't I? Take a look at my girlfriend. She's the only one. Speaking of like creators I enjoy. AlphaRad. I definitely like went through like a proper like little AlphaRad phase. Random question time. Ooh, I'm always down for a random question. I love random questions. You ask me the question, or do I ask you the question? What's your favorite pizza topping? Mine is cheese. Do you think if someone made you a smoothie and it was banging with different flavors and all? Yeah. Yeah, I think about that. Often. Love smoothies. But they said, add some brains. They said they added some brains. Like human brain? Is it just like, how would I feel? Would I drink it? Because like, I'd probably be fine with it, to be honest with you. It depends. Is it? Because if it's like a flavor that's completely unachievable and it like blows my mind and I've never tasted anything like it, then honestly, I'd probably be fine with it. Would I try it? Would I try it if I knew it had brains in it? Yeah. Sure. Would you? I would probably do that, because, like, that's fine, you know? I mean, I would ask questions, obviously. I'd be like, why are there brains? How have you got human brains? I'm a vegetarian, I have morals. Hilarious. I would have to be like, where's it from? You know? How did you get human brain? Are you allowed to do this? Did you kill this person? Should you have brains? I'm now questioning why one of my friends has access to brains. If the maker's last name is Lecter, it might probably taste good. See? You're right. But yeah, because like, I don't think I know anyone who would get access to brains. And like, you know, if someone is enthusiastic enough about eating people that they can just get a brain, then I don't think I want to be friends with them, you know? Yeah, where, and the brain is fucked up. Is, like, this is the thing. I, like, cannibalism as a whole is obviously, like, terrible. Either they're a murderer or rich. If they're, like, rich, I don't know, it depends, right? Because if they are, if it's something I, like, knew and was pre-established, I'd probably try it. Someone clip that I like cannibalism, please. Fuck, I didn't finish that thought, did I? I just said I like cannibalism. No, I'm not. Cannibalism is insane. Don't eat people. However, what's the problem with eating people if it's consensual, you know? And I don't mean ass eating, I mean like, if someone, like, chops off a finger and is like, you can eat it, it's for you, bro. You go crazy. Crazy? I was crazy once. That's it. I'll leave that at that. Frame small picture. Can't process the chemicals and all that. Oh, I'm different. I probably could. Oh no, I'd be fine. Like, I think I'd try it. I know that there's like, the whole nutrition of it is dubious at best. But like, again, here's the question is like, where did it come from? That's way more important to me than like, what is it? I don't know why. If someone says, like, this will explicitly kill you, I'd probably give it a go still. Because, like, why not? I'll eat poison. Fuck it. I will try... Oh, should I taste test cyanide on camera? Can you do that? How much cyanide is enough to kill you? Eating the brain of another human being can cause kuru, a brain disease that's similar to mad cow disease. Kuru occurs because our brains contain prions that transmit the disease. Symptoms begin with trembling and end in death. Interesting. I remember there was outrage at some point because some pop-up restaurant thing where they'll draw your blood and use it for dishes. No, that's fucking cool. And also, why is... What's there to get outraged about if it's your blood? And you're choosing to go there, and you're paying the people to do it. Come on. Come on. I mean, I guess, you know, it's like, oh, are they sanitary? Are they doing this? Should you be, like, drawing blood around food? Alright. It's a bit dubious. It's a bit dubious. I would... See, for some reason, I wouldn't do that. If someone was like, there's a restaurant where they draw your blood and they make meals out of it, do you want to go? I'd be like, no, I won't do that. I don't know why, but that's just gross to me for some reason. Like, it just feels unhygienic. I'm more likely to eat a human being than I am to drink my own blood. Sorry to all my vampire followers. No! Do I have any multi-purpose cleaner? I do! Soap kind of sucks in this game. I don't know why I keep trying it. I don't know, what? Would you eat any part of a human then? Because, like... I don't know, you know? I feel like... I don't know, as long as they're testing it. Well. 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 Well, well, well. Probably not, but I don't eat meats anyway. Yeah, no, that's fair. I feel like if you don't eat meat, then you're just like instantly probably in the moral right in this situation, right? Because it's not a matter of, oh, I want to eat meat. I don't want to eat human. It's like, I don't eat meat. And that's like a normal thing. I think... I don't know. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe. That's metal, that's why that's not working. Cool. Keep forgetting that the beams are made of metal in this. I don't have any metal cleaner. The beams. Me every time I use soap. God, soap in this is so fucking useless. Continues to use it over and over again. That was my random question. I have a lot and confuse my friends. Ask me more questions. That sounds awesome. I'm down for more. I'm always down for more questions. I'm a big fan of random questions. Mostly because I like to get randomly opinionated on stuff for no reason. Now I'm drawing a blank. Yeah, that's fair. That happens. No pressure, buddy. Oh no. I'd say the thing is, there are so many questions like that, but they're all like fucked up and weird and sexual. Like terrible, terrible would you rathers, you know? Would you rather have your big toe cut off or your last two toes? On either foot. Probably. My last two toes? Probably my last two toes. Because then I wouldn't be able to wear flip-flops. And, like, I know that there's that saying that's like, ooh, if you didn't have your pinky toe, you wouldn't be able to balance or whatever. I don't know how true that is. So I'm gonna say fuck it and get my toes cut off, right? And my entire reasoning for that is, like, flip-flops. I think you can look more normal without, like, little toes at a glance. Whereas, like, I think a big toe would be noticeable very quickly. Might just be me. I would like to just have one big toe on each foot and one big finger. You want to be like you want what's it called? What about the same but with fingers? Again, probably, yeah, I'd get my like pinkies, my like end fingers cut off, because I use these three when I use a controller. Maybe I'll go this far. It's that thumb picture. I want to be the thumb people in Spy Kids. Yeah, yeah. I think that's what Ali's talking about. Lots of talk. I have no idea that's what it is, but yes. There's no idea. Lots of talk about like dismemberment today. I'm feeling. I'm not sure why. I'm not necessarily complaining. It's interesting. What else? Have you got any weird questions for us, Ali? I feel like you would. I don't know why. You give me has weird questions vibes. That's so... I wasn't saying it to be mean. It is strange if I make a pipe bomb. I don't, like, okay, look, I'm gonna tell you this once, do not make a pipe bomb. Just don't do it. I'm sorry, but don't do it, it's not worth it. Don't do that, don't ever do that. There was, do you remember that kid in, it's so easy to make, it's quick, it's easy, and it's free, making a pipe bomb. Do you remember, this is like kind of obscure, but I must not be the only person who remembers this. It was during the Obama administration in America. There was a kid who made a clock for show and tell. And he made a clock, and it was like found to be like nuclear powered or something, and he got in like loads of trouble. And then like after a while, he became like a scientist or something. It worked out in the end. But my point is he accidentally made something dangerous, and he got in shitloads of trouble for it. I think making a pipe bomb might be the worst thing you could do. Because, like, accidentally making a pipe bomb, sure, happens. Happens to the best of us. We've all been there. 5 minute crafts, bigger than before. Big egg, bigger than before. So basically, if you got about 5,000 smoke detectors, he would fucking go. He would fucking go. You will. And I'm gonna get nerdy and science-y. That's good. Surprisingly, you could buy radioactive material fairly easy. Well, are we talking like things with a lot of potassium that also hold a lot of like radons, or are we talking like actual things that radiate and mutate you? Because you have enough American. You have enough American to basically run a mini nuclear reactor. I don't think you should do that. I don't think you should do that. Like, honestly, I think you're more likely to just end up with cancer than anything. Don't worry, I'm not doing that. I'm just making a pipe bomb. Also, don't do that. Don't. No. No. Chat, do not make a pipe bomb. They'll just, like, let you buy natural uranium ore. It's not enriched, so you're not going to be much of a problem unless you try to enrich it yourself. How does one enrich uranium ore? Asking for a friend? That friend is Ali. Chat, buy uranium and make bombs. X-rays. Shall I add uranium ore to the throne? To the throne wish list. Type !! Throne and, and you can buy me uranium. I would love that. That would be nice. Good fucking lord, there's a lot of stuff to play in here. Our school, we actually do have some radioactive material. Is that like in the like science area? Because I think we had stuff like that as well. We had like a controlled substances area, which I think is insane, frankly. In the lead boxes, we got a hideaway. It's the microwave. Who up Michaeling their wave right now? Insane. From the kids, I'll throw the box at them. Honestly, if it makes them behave, good. Oh, Jesus Christ, that scared me. Oh my god. Hi, Sasa. Thank you so much for the raid. Oh my god, that really surprised me. Sasa raid, but I stole creature. I can't believe you stole creature. How could you do that? Thank you so much for the raid. How are you doing? Hey, Squiddy, how's it going? Just to get a quick introduction out of the way, hello, raiders. For everyone who is new, I'm Kiri. I have a variety stream. I'm doing Powerwash at the moment, which is just, like, chill. We're chatting. We were just talking about whether or not we would eat a brain. So we've got that going for us, which is nice. Good, very EP though. Go rest. I don't know how long you were streaming for. I hope it was, like, a good stream, but, like, do what you need to do, man. Like, look after yourself. Up, Liver. Later, we're making pipe bombs. No! We're not making pipe bombs. Oh, I knew. Hope you are fabulous. Feel free if you just need to raid and run, all of you. Like, take care of yourself. I'm gonna go make a sandwich tonight, no problem. Have a good night. Thank you so much for the raid. In the morning, I'm making waffles. Night, guys. Thanks for being here. Love you lots. Very much. We're actually kind of at the tail end of my stream as well, but I appreciate you all being here. It's been lovely. But yeah, for anyone who's unsure, I stream, I do variety stuff, it's nice. That's it. I do Power Wash every Wednesday, where I disable apparently most of my sound alerts, because I didn't realise that you could still make sound with a raid. Hence why it scared me so much. But yeah, this is kind of the chill day. Wednesday is the chill day. Yesterday I was playing VTM. How has days been? What's been going on? Does anyone have any weird questions to ask? Because we're kind of running low on weird question material. And I need to do something to stop Ali from making a pipe bomb. So I have more, but I will hold off. You don't have to. Powerwash is always a good time. I agree. Also, thank you. I'm just happy. Grr. Me when I try to clean things. So I'm actually doing the Final Fantasy VII DLC at the moment. Buster Sword. Very cool. But would you rather have a constant rain cloud over you, like a flash flood, or a desert heat sun? Constant rain cloud, easily. Like, I hate being hot as it is. Although I guess being like wet because of a rain cloud would be very annoying. But like, I don't know. Too bad you're hot all the time anyway. Like, genuinely, I'm so boiling. Even like inside, I guess the problem with that, right, is you could technically sleep in a heat wave like a little sun. But like, if you're being constantly rained on, waterbed. I don't know, maybe you can like mitigate it. Can I wear like one of those little umbrella caps with a giant lollipop? Waterboarding. Government mandated waterboarding. I once waterboarded my housemate. We were talking about like whether or not he came up to me and was like, is waterboarding that bad? And I was like, yes, it's a form of torture, of course it's that bad. And he was like, no, I don't see how it could be that bad, like, it's just water. So we tried it. He leant in the bath and put towels over his face, and I poured water on it. And like instantly, he was like, I need to get up. So, yeah. I had this exact same thought. This nearly happened to me. Would you like? You want to come over? I can waterboard you if you want. I did something similar but not as bad. Please elaborate. KyriDoulou offering free waterboard. I got into a drunken argument with my friends. Uh-oh. What about? I said that it's a waste to bin the banana skins? No, you didn't eat a banana skin. To be fair, have you ever bitten into a banana, like, without peeling it, and it makes, like, the most satisfying crunch sound in the world? You can't eat a banana skin. Also, I bet they, like... I don't know, I bet you just can't chew them, right? They are edible, technically. Really? Bet them I could eat one whole. How much did you bet? Did, like, was this a monetary bet? I think it should be edible. If you blend it, maybe. It can't taste good. It's like, they're like waxy, no? My god, it made my mouth go all funny. You know that feeling with certain fruits? Oh, they're like kind of like numb feeling that people get. It makes the inside of your mouth like furry. Wait, no? Maybe you're allergic. Perhaps. Perhaps, what's it to you? Totally get what you mean. What? This is a universal experience? Surely not. Very nice. Happens with unripe dates. Interesting. It happens to my housemate Jaden when they eat raw spinach. Like, they used to put spinach and stuff all the time, like sandwiches and stuff, and they had to stop because it kept making their mouth tingle. Going to come into your house and bring you all sorts of food that's just going to fuck up the textures in your mouth. That would be so fucking funny. You should do it. Weird texture stream. We should also get my two autistic housemates to join in because they're both very weird about textures. I think that would be very funny. Maybe considered immoral. I totally understand. Hate the feeling of stuff. I understand. Personally, I love the feeling of stuff. But that's just me. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. That stuff makes the world go round. Where? Ah. Oh fuck, they're individual? No. Closest to me describe it is peach fuzz skin texture. I hate when I eat a mango. I don't like mangoes. I don't think I've ever eaten a ripe one. Like, I'm sure I would like mangoes. I just, every time I try one, they're like hard. They're always too hard. Which I assume is like, just because they're not ripe and not because mangoes are just hard. You gotta slap some bananas on them to ripen it up. I wish we had a fruit bowl. You know those fruit bowls that have got like the little hook for bananas? I wish we had one of those. I love kitchen shit. I love buying kitchen shit. Cool. What could I be missing? Oh, table. Damn, I missed a lot of these. get a fruit ball and place art supplies next to it. What is the best fruit? Bananas, probably, right? They're the most filling. They're delicious. They are good with cereal, they go good with smoothie, they're a good dessert. Bananas for sure, right? Like, hands down. Although, I actually became intolerant to bananas, like, randomly, when I was in Mexico. Like 5 or 6 years ago, and I couldn't eat bananas for, like, 2 years. And then I just got over it one day. Like, bananas can't tolerate them. Yeah, literally. I just, one day I ate a banana and it gave me, like, the worst stomach ache I'd had in my life. And I was like, oh, it must have been, like, a bad banana. And then every single time I ate a banana, it would happen again and again and again and again and again. So, bad banana. Yeah, bad banana. Yeah, bad banana. Ah. I actually have been finding it fun lately in Powerwash to like hunt for dirt that I've missed. I don't know why. Oh god, I'm becoming old. I'm like becoming like actually old, I think. I see something, I'm like, there you are! I'm cursed by hearing the same jokes every time people that know I'm queer find out I don't like bananas. Oh god. Yeah, that's fair. Oh, hey Fish, how's it going? Thanks for swinging by. How has your day been? We're just talking about what the best fruit is. What do you guys think the best fruit is? Because I've just kind of decided it's bananas. But like, I don't blame you for disagreeing. Cloud's butter sword. Lychee, forgotten fruit. I used to call lychees eyeballs because I'd only ever tried lychee in a all-you-can-eat Chinese restaurant called Aroma that we used to have in the town I grew up in. And they, I'd only ever seen like peeled, and then my brother was like, ooh, you're eating eyeballs. I was like, so they were just known as eyeballs from now on. But then like, lychee is probably one of my favorite flavors for other things to be. Like, my favorite bubble tea is black tea with, like, lychee. But lychee syrup, oh, hot salad. Yeah, fun to eat. Big on pears. Like pears. I used to fucking love pears. I, like, genuinely really used to love pears. They used to be my favorite. And then one day, they just started tasting like cardboard to me, and I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened, and I'm really sad about it. Cabinet light? Cabinet light. How am I supposed to get that? There we go. Ah. Second, my cat's trying to get in. Ooh! He's good. Honestly, I like most fruits. One thing I'm not really big on is berries. I don't know if that's controversial. Like, I know strawberries technically aren't berries, but like, I don't know, I think strawberries are a bit overrated. I think raspberries are like, they're kind of weird tasting, I don't know. To be honest, blueberries just make me feel like they are a fruit that's just trying to be healthy. Blueberries actually might be my favorite of the berries. I used to buy blueberries and bananas and put them in my cereal to like make myself feel a little bit healthier. And then I realized that I was still eating like 10,000 calories or whatever with my cereal, so I just started eating the fruit. Blueberries also give me the weird. All this chat about fruit, I've just stuffed most of a shitload of Doritos down my gob. Honestly, good for you. I'm jealous. What flavor Doritos? Cool original. Because those are the most Moorish. Blueberries with the weird fuzzy texture. Maybe it's a... Are you sure? Cheese. No, cheese is good. Cool original. Or what are they called elsewhere? Cool ranch. I have a crisp hot take, to be honest. Ooh. Do elaborate. I'm listening. Listening like a fucking hawk. I think sensations are all garbage and I hate them. No, that's actually not on. Sensations are delicious. Like, I don't like sweet chili at all, but Thai sweet chili sensations are the best. Get out of here. Everyone says the same thing. Because I don't like sweet chili. And Thai sweet chili sensations are the best. I'm sorry, I can't, like, you're wrong. You're wrong. I can't take it anymore, it's because you're wrong. No, you're wrong, that's not on, I'm not happy with this. Cabin. Ah. Like, to be fair, I've not had sensations in quite a long time. It's objectively my hot... That's because you're wrong. I mean, like, that's not a hot take. You're just wrong. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But... Have you considered being less wrong? To be fair, though, I've not had sensations in a while. I'm trying to... I've never bought them in my life. That's because you've never truly tried anything. You've never lived... Like, there are hot takes, and then there's just, like, being wrong. And, unfortunately, you do fall into the latter category. Normally, I'm all ambivalent. Like, no, you know, people can have different opinions. It's okay. Mm-mm. Shrimply not okay. Where is the fuse box? Where's the fuse box? Ah. Ah. I'll see myself out with a packet of pickle onion monster. I mean, to be fair, those also fuck very hard. Like, you've redeemed yourself. Yeah, like Monster Munch. Mm-hmm. All right. Thoughts on Space Raiders, the crisps. How do we feel about cheap artificial cheese flavor that has you taste the heavy metals in it? I'm a fan. Are they the 20p ones? Yeah, I don't know if they are still 20p, but they used to be. I swear they used to be like 9p. I swear, I know that this is literally how inflation works, but I swear I've been like noticing things get more expensive lately. I love... like cheap artificial cheese flavorings. there's like when you eat so much of it that it kind of hurts your mouth a little bit. And like, to clarify, I mean when you eat like loads of it. Cozy lives in it. The old Cozy Lives short stool. Wall lantern. PlayStation. Cozy, my beloved. If my nachos don't taste like copper, I don't want them. Yes! Oh, it's so good. And like, alright, so on the flip side though, there's a wrong way to do that cheap shit cheese, and that's how cinemas do it, because their cheese just tastes like sweat. Like actual just tastes like kind of salt, warm and salty and a bit gross. Ah. The cum cheese. You know, that's why lip blood tastes nice, because it's loaded with iron. Isn't all blood loaded with iron? Or is it just lip blood? Ah. Nacho cheese in general is just mediocre ass cheese. Yeah, you're right. Hee hee, ass cheese. Tifa told me that I have to make sure you did your job. Not bad. You're the real deal. Your lips especially. Cuts on your lips. I don't taste my own blood a lot. Marco energy exhibit. Very cool. Okay, I've got a couple more things to do. But I think that's basically it for today. Because I'm so sleepy. And to be honest with you, I thought I'd be done. Like half an hour ago. Who should I raid? Who up sampling their bodily fluids? No one I follow is online right now. Which is incredibly sad. Raid me. Are you gonna stream? I can. If you want me to. Or are you just asking me to like swat your house or something? Is D-Man gonna stream? Or... I'm gonna... Careful, the pipe bomb. I'll stream again in the future, I'm sure. Maybe. I will. I had some great streams. I actually saw a couple of those. I mean, not live, but I saw some VODs. Or some, like, clips. I thought it was very entertaining. Come watch me make a pipe bomb. No, that's it. I'm sending you to Tortle. He's not. Right, no, fuck it. No, I don't even know if Tortle's gonna stream tonight. So I'm gonna go on Twitch, and I'm gonna find someone. Anyone got a favorite streamer? Can't wait to go back. Join me. The unperceivable rumpus. Wine Wednesday. I'm gonna send you to someone. Someone drawing Pikmin? Yeah, I'm gonna send you to someone who's making a 3D model of Pikmin. I'm gonna send you to a VTuber who's making a 3D model of a Pikmin. I've never watched this streamer any before, so if they're not good, I'm sorry. But also be very kind to them, please. Their name is Ray Spark. I'm not gonna leave a raid message. Alright. Be nice. Thank you so much for being here. Good night. Thank you for being here again. Love you lots.